Hello, I'm a Felicity friends. Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is KJ Ricardo, and today's episode is a guest star spotlight on Harry Bartell. Now, you're probably wondering, who's that? Well, he was a guest star on I Love Lucy, and he is probably best known for playing the waiter in LA Last at the Brown Derby, but he was also in The Great Train Robbery, and he was in one other episode. But we might not know so much about him and his career, so let's get into his biography. So Harry was born on November 28, 1913 in New Orleans, Louisiana, and he passed away on February 26, 2004. He was born in New Orleans, but he grew up in Houston, Texas, where he got his start in radio at KRPC. He graduated from Rice University in 1933, and he attended Harvard Business School. He worked in retail for a while, but he took a break to serve in the U.S. Army during World War II. He realized he really wanted to work in the radio industry, so he moved to Los Angeles in 1942 to work as a disc jockey for KFWB, located on the Warner Brothers lot. While there, he simultaneously studied acting at the Pasadena Playhouse. Harry became a favorite of radio director producer Norman McDonald, and he performed in a variety of radio programs like Escape, Gunsmoke, and on that show he played friendly townspeople to victims and many more roles. With fellow actor Vic Perrin, Harry even wrote two episodes near the radio show's end in 1961, and then, of course, it was made into a successful TV show. Harry became known as old-time radio actor because he appeared in so many radio programs during this time, mostly westerns including The Six Shooter, Have Gun, Will Travel, Dragnet. He was the announcer on The New Adventures of Sherlock Holmes. Looking at Harry's film career, he didn't appear in that many films, but he appeared in a few, including Destination Tokyo, which was his very first screen debut, as well as Dragnet, the movie version of the successful TV show, as well as Voice in the Mirror, and a few others. But looking at screen performances, Harry would become more well-known as a TV guest star. He had a youthful voice and appearance that made him one of the West Coast's busiest character actors in the 1940s, 50s, and 60s. He appeared in so many TV shows, including Dragnet, The Loretta Young Show, as well as Bonanza and The Untouchables, as well as Gunsmoke, which he was on the radio program, Get Smart, as well as The Wild Wild West, Twilight Zone, and of course, we have to look at I Love Lucy. So he appeared in three episodes of I Love Lucy, and each role is pretty recognizable. One of them probably isn't as recognizable, and you probably didn't know that it was him, but we're going to look at each of these episodes. So the first episode is The Courtroom, where he plays a process server. And so in this episode, the Ricardos gave the Mertzes a TV set for their anniversary. It was a really nice present, but things go wrong when the TV set explodes. And of course, Fred gets mad at Ricky. He goes upstairs to the Ricardos and kicks in the Ricardos' TV set. And this leads to a huge fight. And everyone's gonna sue each other. And Harry Bartell guest stars in this episode in one scene where he comes over to the Ricardos and pretends that he wants to have Ricky's signature, his autograph, because he's a fan, but it was actually a notice that Fred was suing Ricky. And it's just a nice little guest star spot. The next episode is LA at Last, and this is probably what you know Harry best for on I Love Lucy. So this episode is the very first episode in California. Lucy, Fred, and Ethel are at the Brown Derby and they see William Holden, but Harry Bartell is in this scene as the waiter and he helps William Holden. He tries to make sure that Lucy doesn't bother him, but Harry does a really great job in this episode as playing an annoyed waiter who tries his best to help out a celebrity. He's great. The last episode is the Great Train Robbery, and in this episode, Harry Bartell has a pretty big part towards the end. This is the episode when everyone is going home from California, and they're traveling home by train, and Lucy thinks that the person in the compartment next to theirs is a jewel thief. That she is convinced that he's a jewel thief. And Harry Bartell plays a real jewel thief, and he overhears this, and so he tricks Lucy into thinking that he is a detective, that he will help her out, but really he just wants the jewels.
Pardon me, miss, I couldn't help overhearing. Are you sure of what you saw?
Positive.
Good work. Special agent. My identification.
Oh, I should have known. I can tell you fellas miles away.
Now you say this. That's great. Pretend you're sick.
Oh, help. For J. Edgar. Oh, look, let's put the cuffs on him. Come on, let's put the cuffs on him. Let's put the cuffs on him. Hurry up. Oh, boy. Come on, let's put the cuffs on him. Well, you don't need that. He's unconscious. Oh, boy. Let's put the cuffs on him. You don't need that. He's unconscious.
I know.
I made a boo-boo. He's not the man the police are looking for?
No.
You?
True.
Looking into his personal life a little bit, Harry loved photography. He had his own photography darkroom at his house in North Hollywood. He even took photos of the Gunsmoke cast, which appeared in the 1990 book Gunsmoke, A Complete History. Not much is known about Harry's personal life, but I do know that he had one son, Bill Bartell. In his later years, Harry attended old-time radio conventions and recreations. He wrote online articles about the radio industry, and he even participated in radio-themed chat rooms, which had to be a completely different experience for him to be participating in an online chat room. But he stayed connected to radio all his life. He never really forgot it, and I just love that about him. On February 26, 2004, Harry died in Ashland, Oregon. He was 90 years old. And that's it. That's all I have for you this week. I hope you enjoyed this biography and tribute to Harry Bartell. He loved the radio industry. He loved it and wanted people to support it. It was his first love, his first and true love. He had such a strong passion for it, and he's best remembered for that. He was also a very memorable guest star, including on I Love Lucy, and you just can't forget him as the waiter in the Brown Derby in LA at Last. It's just, he does such a great job in whatever role he is a part of. And so I hope you enjoyed this guest star spot on him. Let me know what you enjoyed best, and I would be happy to read that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time with another video. And remember to always laugh often.